Johnny Bazookatone. So this is a long box game. So early PS1. And US Gold responsible for this one. I think US Gold, I think I remember them for making, like, let's say bad NES and Super NES games. I think that's what they're mostly known for like, let's say licensed bad games are what I think US Gold got up to in their publishing and developing times. Alright, Johnny Bazookatone. Fire or laser? What about both? Can it be fire lasers? Save the soul of rock and roll. The hottest thing to hit rock and roll is Johnny Bazookatone. Mr. El Diablo, Lord of the Underworld. Sure. Okay, so Anita platforming ensues. Rock on with SGI rendered characters. Incredible special effects, capital S. CD quality sound backs the mega tunes. We got a bazooka. Hold on. We got a bazooka guitar. I wish there were a better way to resize stuff. Spews electric riff tunes and ultra blast tunes. Okay. 360 rotation jumps and hover jumps. In a 3D scrolling environment. That doesn't look 3D to me. That environment. That looks like pre-rendered flats. But sure. So SGI, that's how they did the like Mario RPG and Donkey Kong Country. So this could have literally been a Super Nintendo game, minus the CD music. Alright. So one player. This doesn't have memory card support, evidently. No analog support. And all that. Hey, Gator. Yeah, SGI. I think all of the PlayStation development stuff was part of, like, SGI was part of their tool chain. Like, if you're doing textures and all that, you had to make them on SGI workstations or something like that. They had some sort of racket going. Alright, Save the Soul of Rock and Roll. We got a pretty low rent advertisement here for this. This is not a good advertisement. Includes title track featuring Richie Sambora and Tico Torres from Bon Jovi. Alright. Sure. Also available on... Hold on, let's see what else this is on. What other consoles is this afflicted on? PC, CD-ROM, Sega Saturn, PlayStation, and 3DO. Oh, baby. Copyright 1995. Alright. It's a very, very, very early PS1 game. Alright. Do I have anything else here? Not really. Okay. Alright, well. This might be another game that has a ton of deaths in it, so we'll see how that goes. Probably not well, if I had to guess. Okay. Let's take this Chrono Cross disc out. I had to test that thing earlier. Alright, Johnny Bazookatone. Let's see how this one's going to be. Shit. Okay. Johnny Bazookatone, huh? A blast. Alright, you're predicting it's gonna be a blast. Alright. Man, I'm so glad I figured out. I mentioned before, I figured out what was wrong with my with the video. This used to be, like, really washed out and looked like I had the brightness up too high. It was actually a video card setting that I accidentally turned on when I was trying to make Morrowind look better. So, as usual, Morrowind was fucking up the rest of my stream. As usual. What a surprise. Of course it was Morrowind. Okay. Surprise of the century. Alright, let me open my window. It's already getting hot in here. All right, Johnny Bazookatone. Oh man, he's got a soul patch too. I didn't notice that. All right. This doesn't sound like rock and roll. Okay, there we go. It sounds more like Eurobeat rather than rock and roll. Or like an anime opening. Sounds just like my Japanese animes. Yeah, this is music to race cars down hills very quickly, too. When does this intro end? Hopefully never. Hopefully this is the whole game. It's already been 2 minutes of this, by the way. Is that guitar pissing itself? Now it's blood, okay. Now it's purple drink. Add this to the playlist? Okay, I will. Let me actually see if the soundtrack for this is up. Let me check my sources to see if the soundtrack for this is anywhere. Johnny Bazookatone soundtrack is not on the internet, it seems. That's lame. But don't you worry, I'll rip this song. I'll get a clean recording of this song. I've actually got it already, because, wow. Because I record my commentary on a separate track, so. Alright. Pogo, yo, this is Keen. Or DuckTales, also just as good. I'm assuming the green arrows on the shoulder buttons are the top two. Alright, power up, jump. Who puts jump on square? Also, there's a suck button. Alright, pogo run, fire, fire. Why do they have to combine pogo and run on the same button? Alright, I guess I gotta use type. Alright, I'll just use type A, I guess. Power up suck. Sure. Alright. Music test. Soul, rock, Anita. Alright, we already heard that. Sushi. This is some rock music here. This is just Jaws. This. Get John Williams' lawyers on the phone. Yo. There's nothing techno about this.
It's a dream.
Shit. Alright. Oh baby, this is still not techno though.
It's a dream.
Okay. Alright, well... Bonus song. Yo, why isn't the soundtrack on the internet? Disco Diablo. Alright. Well, here's where we get the clean rip of that intro song. Alright, good. I can appreciate a good sound test. So I need to have my text thing open here for passwords, it looks like. Alright, 8 minutes in, let's finally play the game. So there isn't going to be a save icon for this, or saves, it seems. We're going to rock hell, apparently. Alright, so right off the bat. So this is a bit like Earthworm Jim. Alright. Alright. don't know how you pogo. Alright, so those stars in the upper left must be held. Dude, this is practically Earthworm Jim. Except with better songs. Depending on what you're into. Better soundtrack, Earthworm Jim. It looks like I have infinite ammo. Oh good, it puts you right back at the start. Alright, are these checkpoints? At least it looks like enemies don't respawn. You'd think these would be checkpoints, but apparently not. Probably assume nobody would need a checkpoint this early. They didn't have enough room on the disc for voice acting for Johnny. With all this total the rock music that the game's otherwise got. Alright, we did it. Bullshit enemy out of nowhere. Oh, yo, you can do the Duke Nukem thing. Oh, shit. Great. I'm out of lives already. All right. There's only 5 levels, apparently. And there's a code for God mode, but we'll give it a bit before we get to that, I guess. Alright, we're still figuring out the controls. But yeah, there's a hover like Duke Nukem. Like, you can do that and fall down slower. true. Yeah, I have no idea what the extra lives are for. If they grant extra lives, then it's not at 100. It defies video gaming convention by not giving you extra lives at 100. I'm not. So if you hold on to the run button while you're doing your gun jetpack thing. Oh, you can. Alright, maybe I can just make this. Oh. So you don't even have to go up there. What? Okay, so only. Only some of those mushroom heads are jump. Hey, Chicky. High jump. And the red ones will hurt you. Good lord. Does anything not hurt you in this game? We're getting there. We made slightly more progress. It'd be nice if the game gave you like more frequent checkpoints or something, but it appears there's only passwords for complete levels. There's five levels apparently, and there's a password for the start of each one, besides the first one of course, because you can just get here from new game. But, oh my god. Ooh, baby. I knew this one would be quite the struggle, and I was right, apparently. right? For whatever reason, it just kind of stopped running. Sure. Can't make that jump without running. But if you don't run, or if you do run, you run right into that thorn. Those damage boosts. Whoa, don't kill me, don't kill me! Okay. Fuck's sake! Game. Getting close to just turning on the god mode, and then we'll see what the rest of this game is like. This fucking game. This game is not fun so far. This reminds me of 16-bit platformers in a bad way. There's a reason why I'm not doing play all the Genesis games or all the Super Nintendo games. So they can jump up through platforms, but I can't fall through them. The bottom and left. But why did... Why do I not fall slowly that time? So it's inconsistent for when it gives you the slow fall. Oh, shit. Alright, get dunked on, dog. Or not. Can't kill the dog, apparently? For fuck's sake. Just... Like, here, can I... That doesn't do anything to that. Oh, shit. Pulling the fuck this game card on this one. 27 minutes in and probably like 10 minutes of gameplay in. We're going full fuck this game mode. This is not fun. That's all I have to do there. Alright, that's the code apparently. Alright, let's do this. So hopefully that gives me invincibility, and then we can just fly through this thing and then put it in the garbage. Alright, invincibility. Look at that, alright. A speedrun time. In there. No, that's not a new record for fuck this game. Alright, I stole the platform. And I'm assuming pitfalls will still get me. But, man, fuck this game. Just fuck this game. Like, that would have hit me. What a bad video game. What a bad video game this is. Like this dog, how are you... Okay, so if you do that, that doesn't do anything against the dog. If you get over here, you just fucked. Apparently. Can I not even get past the dog? Yeah, so if you get over here... Okay, there we go. Yeah, and then if you get up here, you're probably gonna get hit by these things. And then you're probably gonna get hit by those and you fall in here. At least the soundtrack is good for this one, but holy shit. This is a bad video game. Now there's two dogs. So anytime you even get touched by one of those dogs, you get ruined. And there's one extra life. Alright. Alright, sure. We'll take that damage boost, I guess. No, maximum fuck this game is I just stop playing. You have a pretty weird scale for maximum fuck this game. And that one was the Magic game. Magic the Gathering Battle Mage. That one was the quickest from zero to, hey, let's not play this game ever again. Double 7 Racing, I actually got to the end. Can I not do anything here? In the dark, we actually finished. Oh, supposed to suck up the key. Okay, so that's what the suck command is for. So did anyone else notice that key that was there? The dark red key. Against the dark background. Look at this thing. Dark red key. All right. We've sure got this key. I would sure love to use it to maybe unlock this door. I mean, that's L1. No? I thought there was a, like, use item button. There's probably a different door that I need to open. Yeah, it's sliding somewhere over here. This one. There we go. All right. For the other key. Whoop. And we have to suck up this other key. That's really hard to spot. All right, in there. Oh, good. Oh, good. Yep, use that key to get another key. Sure. Oh, good. We need another key. My favorite. And then platforms that just kind of disappear. Oh, another key. Alright. Was there a red door somewhere? I don't even remember seeing a red door. Man, this game went so far downhill after that hot anime intro. And up there. There's so much potential with that hot anime intro. Completely squandered. See, there. Why am I still falling fast? I'm shooting down. Oh. It's like there it lets me glide. No key. Oh boy. Alright. There it is. Wait, no, that's... Well, I found the red door and the black key. Here we go. There it is. Alright, red key. Cool video game. We got you figured out, video game. All right, black key. Black door was... like 10 levels below me, I think. Oh, it's right there, okay. Oh, cool, I can't open the black door anymore. I do that. Wait, did I... Oh. Okay. I could have just jumped over the fucking door. All right, sure. There's a red key. Alright, let's get rid of that key. Nice. Awesome level design. Got another one of the- what? Sure, fine. Sure. Yeah, like these one-way stairs are pretty good. This is gun as infinite ammo. Still. don't need that. That would have killed me. Huh. So maybe it's intended that you could skip that key earlier. This level just keeps going, right? This is longer than all the other levels combined so far. I want to see if there's at least some redeeming value in this. I have a feeling there isn't, but you never know. This could turn into like a really good game at some point, right? Right? Gotta hold out. Hold out hope. Charon's pedal taxi. One silver coin per 20 feet. What? Wait, I'm supposed to pay him for, video game. Whoa. Cool. Hey, we have God mode on, and we just died. Cool, it ate my jump. I love when it does that. Well, guys, get your boats in. Get your boats in, boys. I think what we're gonna do is go to the main menu in this, listen to the soundtrack a few times. And then, yeah, it ate my... It didn't let me glide there. Alright, let's see what level 2 looks like, I guess. I probably won't have a... Let's not continue. Let's see what level 2 looks like. See if level 2 is any better. All This should start me on level 2. Alright. Hey, we can see the FMVs at least. Alright. This will be much better than actually playing this piece of shit game. We can listen to the music and see the cutscenes. Yeah, that was all part of level one. You only get passwords on every like chapter, I guess. And we were on like level 1-4, and you only have a few lives to make that work. All right, so there's those things again. Yeah, it's pretty cool, right? Oh, cool, and those things can just fucking shoot you. Alright, so we got some Sonic. Literal Sonic platforms. Yep, pretty much the same enemy. Cool. Cool game. All right, we did it. You can skip that guy. All right. Okay, so you can root of those at least. Okay. If the dash, the frame is hand moves forward. All right, let's do it. Oh. And you only have one chance at it, apparently. Got this. All right, too early. I think this probably like boosts you up and over him. not even sure, like, am I supposed to be jumping that frame? Or what does this accomplish? At least the song's good. Alright, because it's too early. Looks like you probably have to hit R1 just prior to hand hitting you, and then you clip through the hand sprite. But it like moves you back a little bit when you do it. You know what, guys? Get your votes in. I think we're done with Johnny Bazookatone. The song is pretty good. But, man, this game. A 95 PS1 game, and boy, does it show. I know it says 96, but the copyrights are for 95. Yeah. Yeah, trying to get this clip is more fun than actually playing the game. Yeah. Well, so there isn't even a... like a save icon for this. So let's see what the other FMVs look like. It'll be practically like playing a game, right? Alright, Teaspoon is level 3. Oh, this is shown at a GDQ? Oh, man. Was it an awful Games Done Quick? Alright. I don't remember this at GDQ, but if it's during an awful block, then that's probably why, because I don't watch awful blocks. What even hurt me there? Alright. Cool level. Cool level. Oh, it was AGDQ this year? Huh. Alright. Well, if you want to see the game, watch that instead of this, I guess, because we're not going to see much more of this. Tasks can't reliably do the skip either. Nice. Hellspital. Nice. Alright, I'm fishing for positives here for the game. I do like that there's a lot of, like, interactive level elements. Of course they can jump into you. Alright, Ward 1. Do it. Level. Yeah, there's been zero bazookas in Johnny Bazookatone so far. All right, final level. Yeah, it's a colorful game. I could make this even muddier looking. Like, here's what it looks like through a dazzle. This is closer to how it would look on a CRT. Like that. That's the difference between the Framemeister and on a CRT. So I don't know, maybe it looks slightly better on a CRT. But I like the clean Frame Meister. Alright. Just everything hurts you in this level, apparently. What? Just infinitely spawning. Wait, did it just drop a key? I don't even know what the hell you're supposed to do on this level. Oh, you just kill everything. Okay. Sure. Alright. Final boss, boys. Continue. Okay, we already saw that. All right, we're gonna beat this final boss. I do like this final boss song. We'll be right back. Boss seems simple enough. Alright, if this is anything like Donkey Kong Country, then this can't be the end. Or it is. Okay. Is that really the final boss? Final boss is easier than the first level in the game. If that was actually the final boss. Well, this guitar appears to have 5 strings on it, and only 4 tuner things on the head. Also. Rainbow bonus is 0. Alright. Okay, that was the final boss. That is... Alright, good job, Craig Davidson. Craig Davidson, you did a bang-up job with this original idea. Good job. Chibzy. Our lead programmer, Chibzy. Paul Walker, oh man. He took some before he made it big, being Fast and Furious. He's making the graphics for Johnny Bazookatone. Attila Roth, that's a pretty good name. Alright, the designers, these are the people that you can really give them the good old, the double bird, the Pat Toner and Rich Carlos. Those two, you can blame for this one. Thank you. Thank you for the host. Andy McGinty, you did a bang-up job. You did a pretty good job, Andy. Des Tong, you did a pretty good job, too. Yeah, this credits music's really good. I don't think the credits music were in the music test either. The just game over. And it just kicks it back to the main menu. Yeah, so the credits. Not even in here. The intro to this game pretty cool. You need a new follower alert. Here you go. There you go. Or that one. That one's pretty good too. Alright, it's only 40 things in the FX test. Okay, well, since you can't save in this game... Johnny Bazookatone, huh? Okay. If you have any last minute dank memes, now would be a great time. To share them with the class. Okay. Well, I don't know what they would save. Like, the checkpoint system in this game is brutal. So I honestly don't know what they would save for this. Alright, this is 117. Alright. This one had a lot of dank memes, comparatively. Coolest... tunes ever composed for a video game. Guitar with three strings, sure. Sax solos. Suck button. Anita. Business suit, Satan, not Stan, Satan. Not knowing which parts of the level can hurt you. Boxes. College graduate dog. Business suit, Satan, not Stan. Satan. Not knowing which parts of the level can hurt you. Because it's not obvious. Guitar waifu. Chibzy. And yeah. Final boss was... literally easier than the first level of the game. That's about it, sure. Okay. Things I liked. Colorful, good use of pre-rendered SGI stuff. Music was above average. I really liked the song during the FMV intro. At least it had level passwords. Okay. Things I didn't like. Controls were awful. And floaty. Very little margin for error in any platforming. Tons of blind jumps into things. Tons of blind jumps often into things that hurt / kill you. Can't really tell which things in the level are hazardous. No bazookas. No checkpoints. But no checkpoints, only one continue, it seems. Not immediately clear how to pass some locked areas. Keys that blend into background. Ever that butler thing was. Alright, the list goes on and on. I'll stop it there. Alemows, we were in hell, so that doesn't... I won't count that. Drum and bass? Sure? Sure. Sure. Yeah. Yeah. There was some drum and bass-esque things in there. Did I say Bolter? Typing is hard. Butler. There we go. I did it. Let's see. Yep. That one's easy. Yep. And I think I'll leave this one there. I think you can see why. I think you can see my reasoning. Johnny Bazookatone, not a good video game. Don't play Johnny Bazookatone. Okay. Alright, here's the poll. You got 2 minutes.